In this video, we're studying three problems on exponential functions. Exponential functions and how they relate to personal finances are the most important thing in high school math. Since most people are responsible for saving for their own retirement, if you ever want to retire, you better understand exponential functions. But if you never want to retire, then you never need to understand exponential functions.
Let's go! Solve your math problems.
Now, tap pause to try problem one on your own. As always, start by using my what's the most important word strategy. Here, they're just asking to find which equation defines G. So all we have to do is find the right equation. Immediately, I spot the ordered pair in disguise hiding in the function notation. If G of 0 equals 60, that means we have an ordered pair of 0, 60. I love ordered pairs. They solve so many problems on this test. What do we do with ordered pairs? Don't just stare at them. That's for sure. Just plug them in. So plug in 0 for x and 60 for g of x. And let's see which equation defines g. Using the first equation, when 0 goes in for x, we get 1.19 to the 0 power. Do you know what 1.19 to the 0 power is? Do you know what anything to the 0 power is? If not, you should probably write this down. Anything to the 0 power is 1. So 1.19 to the 0 power turns into 1, and we see that the two sides are equal. I've never been so excited in my whole life. But we have to check each equation. Can you see what's going to happen when you put 0 in for x in every equation? They all turn into 60 equals 60. Let's try to figure out what to do with the fact that the value of g of x is decreasing by 19%. First of all, it's important to review the basic format of an exponential function. You should probably write this down. When you're putting in 0 for x, we were actually finding the y-intercept, which is the starting value of the function. So the multiplier in front is always the starting value of the function. Then, if we want to change the starting value, we will be multiplying it by either 1 plus or 1 minus the percentage of increase or decrease. Stop and think about that for a second. If you multiply something by 1, what happens? Nothing. If you want something to get a little bigger, then you better multiply it by something a little greater than 1. And if you want something to get a little smaller, then you better multiply by something a little smaller than 1. So there's really two versions of this formula. Y equals a times 1 plus r to the x power if you want the item to increase in value. And y equals a times 1 minus r to the x power if you want the amount to decrease. In this problem, we want the values to decrease. So we're going to multiply by 1 minus the percent of decrease. 1 minus 19% is 81%. So the answer is D. Now, stop and think about that for a second, though. If you missed 19% on a test, what percent did you get right? 81%. That's why we have the 0.81 multiplier. Now, tap pause to try problem 2 on your own. This problem is very much like the last problem, So we'll use the same formula. What could possibly go wrong next? Well, I see students mess this problem up year after year, but hopefully you got this one right. We're starting off with 5,000 possums. So that's going to be the multiplier out in front. The starting amount is the y-intercept, and it is always the multiplier in front of an exponential function. So it has to be answer A or B. Unless you're from Alabama, then you can pick D. Which answer is it? Here's where so many students go wrong. They see the 175% and just pick A, because it has a 1.75 right in the answer. If you did that, you're doing it wrong. Let's look closely at the formula. Because the possum population is increasing, we definitely want the version of the formula that uses addition. So we use the 1 plus 1.75, which is 2.75. Students get so used to seeing answers that start with 1 point something that they automatically pick A. But when the percent increase is over 100%, it's not going to start with a 1. It's going to start with a 2. So the correct answer is B. Think about that a little bit more. If something goes up by 100%, it's doubling, right? What do you multiply by to double something? Well, 2, of course. So if something is going up by 100% or more, the multiplier will be 2 or more. Watch out for that on test day. If you just got a little smarter, please like and subscribe so you won't miss any videos. And most importantly, improve your SAT score. Now, tap pause to try problem 3 on your own. Whenever you see a number in a math problem, your eyes should really focus in on that number and ask yourself, what is this doing here? I have a strategy for this that I like to call every number has a purpose, or don't ignore the facts. So if f of 2 is C, what does that mean? That's an ordered pair in disguise. X is 2 and Y is C. Well, don't just stare at ordered pairs. What do we do with them? Just plug them in. So we may not know what we're doing, but we know we're supposed to put a 2 in for X and a C in for Y. Once we do that, only one of these answer choices is easy enough to do in our head. Which one is it? It's answer choice C, because what is 0.89 to the zero power? Well, as we learned, anything to the zero power is 1. So this is 1, and 1 times 4 is 4. Now that we've done that, do you even understand what the question is even asking? We put in 2 and we got out 4. So the ordered pair is 2, 4. And originally the ordered pair was 2, C. So it looks like C must be 4. When you look at the equation and answer choice C, notice how the 4 shows in the function as a coefficient. That's what makes C the right answer. Thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe this video. I'll see you in my next video. And please use the link in the description to do the hardest problems and study on the official practice tests. Please practice.